Hi guys, today we're going to learn something new. We have some error here. If I'm trying to put a primary key on this column, but now on this column there, but now it does what? Give me some error. So I'm gonna go to structure and I'll show you what's going on. So when I go here, I try to change, which is gonna be my editing. So I'm trying to do this auto increment. That simply means it's gonna be what? Like I wanna make this as my primary key. Then I save. When I save, it says query error 1075 incorrect table definition. There can be only one auto increment column and it must be defined as a key. So which means that this is not defined as a key. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna only copy this and I try to make a shortcut, but anyway, if you have another way, it's fine. I'm gonna delete this column and I'll say drop. Let me see, I wanna delete that. Let me see, drop that. Let me do something, drop that. Are you sure you want to hold this table until I drop teacher's ID? Say yes, I've dropped that. So yes, I've deleted that. So what I want to do now, I'm gonna add a column. After what, I'm gonna put it here, beginning of the table. Say okay, I'm gonna name it this, the same thing. I make it to be int value. I want to make it 11. Default key could be none. Index, I say primary key. Then I can say auto increment. Anyway, you leave it like that and say go. Yes, and save. Yes, I've saved. So I've solved that problem now. So that simply means this is our primary key now. You can see now there's a key. Before there was no key. So we've solved the problem. If you find something like that, you can delete the column if you don't have so much data in there. You have to just to be careful. This was a new table for me, but in your case I don't know, but I managed to solve the problem like that. So if I go back here and click on teachers, TBL teachers, yes, you can see it's here. I've got, because there was data already, it says zero. So okay, it's one. So if I go and create another one, I'm gonna say, what can I say? So log in and see something, and say okay. I'm gonna go to what's a registered teacher. I'm gonna get some names, Judy, and I say comma, say M, say this, any number I want. I wanna just confirm that everything we're doing is right. Whatever I pick is fine, and we wanna see if it auto increments. It said thanks, teacher created things. So let's go to our database and see if what we try and do is something relevant. Anyway, I click there. Yes, now we have Judy is on one. It should auto increment, but now the thing is, there was one already. I don't know why it's doing this, but all I want you to see is, let me try to create another one. Let me go back and try to create another person here and here and here. Just I'm just getting shortcuts so that we see if what we've done something relevant. But that should be the solution to that error. Say this was created. So simply mean it didn't create this, though. We're still having that simple problem. I'm sure it didn't create that person. So if we can delete these two, it will create them. So let me delete everything in there. then I see if things gonna go well. So the confusion is there was data before in this table, it was this data, so and I put a primary key that could also cause the problem. So what I'm gonna go back here and create this thing again. Let's get this address. Okay, save. You see, if you see this, it means it's created. And what we're gonna do here, we're gonna go to our DB and see which number did the program give. It gave a zero, no problem. So what we're gonna come here, do we try to create another one, same name, we can use same name, no problem. So we must be for sure if we did solve the problem. We don't want to chance on problems. Okay, we said created, it did not create because there's a zero, so there is still some problem here. The problem comes from our primary key. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna delete this and we say drop, yes, and after that we can go to the table structure and we say, you can see this is like this, and we say change. If we say change, wanna see where did we go wrong. No default, no. Okay, it should be auto incremented. We save, yes, because it's a primary key, so it was not auto increment, so it means it could not create whatever, it has to be inserted. And on our fields here, there's no way we're creating what data like that. So let's go back and see if we solved the second problem. Please guys, don't forget to subscribe and also like our channel and also share our content. Okay, this is created, that's one. I want to create the second one because you saw how we did that. Okay, if we can create a second one, it will show us the green message. That would simply mean that we're done with the problem to let me see, get that right, get this right, and we save. Yes, so now it's working. So the problem also was the third thing was the what, the auto incremention thing. So after when we created the primary key, we didn't give it the auto increment, you see, function. So it was, since it's a primary key, so there's no way on our form here that we create that primary key. So the table requires you to have a primary key, but if you make it auto increment, it creates itself at 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. So we're gonna go to our DB, you're gonna see the same thing which I'm trying to tell you here, that yeah, that makes sense. You can see it's 1, 2, 3, 4. You see now we have teachers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and everything is here. So guys, please don't forget to subscribe. That's the end of our tutorial, and I hope this work for you. Please don't forget to subscribe on our channel. Bye.